A string of bizarre injuries to U.S. diplomats and their families in Cuba has left at least 21 people with a variety of ills, including permanent hearing loss, fatigue, dizziness, visual and balance problems, and sleeping difficulties, and is now being called in attacked by the U.S. government. It's unclear who is behind all of this. The mysterious injuries, which date back to 2016, prompted the U.S. on Friday to take the serious step of removing more than half its embassy staff from the island and warning Americans to avoid traveling there. In addition to the travel warning, the U.S. embassy in Cuba will also stop processing visas indefinitely, U.S. officials said, according to the Associated Press. The reaction from authorities comes months after U.S. and Canadian diplomats alike began reporting loss of hearing, brain injury, and other symptoms. Here are a few answers to questions readers may have about this escalating problem and mystery. Is there any idea what's causing these injuries? Diplomats were said to have reported hearing loud noises or feeling vibrations in Cuban hotels. At times they reported walking in and out of blaring sounds in certain rooms or parts of the rooms, the AP reported. There had been no reports of suspected sounds heard at the U.S. Embassy in Cuba, where 50 Americans are currently working. The State Department issued its travel warning because some of the attacks have happened at hotels in Cuba. When did all this occur, and who is being targeted? Officials told the Associated Press that diplomats began reporting these injuries in the fall of 2016. Canadian diplomats in Cuba also reported similar injuries in March 2017. Those reports, however, did not surface until August, when authorities began to suspect the use of an advanced covert sonic device. The Cuban government was among the first suspects, and in retaliation, the U.S. expelled two Cuban diplomats from their embassy in Washington, D.C. in May. The Cuban government has denied any role in these attacks, and the source remains a mystery. FBI investigators and other agents searched and found no devices at the homes and hotels of U.S. diplomats. Do authorities have any theories about the cause? U.S. authorities first suspected a supersonic device as the cause of the injuries, but investigators have not found any concrete evidence of such. Theories about possible covert weapons used are flying around the internet, but no U.S. officials have been able to confirm those theories. How have U.S. officials and leaders reacted? The injuries rattled U.S. lawmakers so much in mid-September that a group of five senators called on State Secretary Rex Tillerson to expel Cuban diplomats and shut down their embassies in the U.S. At the time, Tillerson said that option was under review. It's a very serious issue with respect to the harm that certain individuals have suffered, Tillerson said on CBS Face the Nation. We've brought some of those people home. It's under review. The Cuban embassy in Washington remained in place, however, despite criticism from Senator Marco Rubio, of Florida, who on Friday said in a tweet that it was shameful that at state debt withdraws most staff from Cuba, but Castro can keep as many as he wants. And U.S. President Donald Trump has not specifically addressed the mysterious attacks on U.S. diplomats there, but he has repeatedly said it was a terrible and misguided deal for former President Barack Obama to reinstate travel to Cuba in 2015. How are others reacting to the travel advisory? For the better part of the last 2 years, Americans have been able to travel to Cuba thanks to a pact reached between the U.S. and the Cuban government in 2015. The U.S. government's issuance of a travel warning and a freeze on visas in Cuba is making some observers recall the days the two countries distrusted each other, while others are saying they visited Cuba recently and would gladly do so again without fear. Could these mysterious attacks put a damper on U.S.-Cuban relations? Should the Trump administration do more, potentially punish Cuba, to protect Americans on the island? Can Cuba be trusted, or do you suspect another country may be involved? So many questions. Share your thoughts as we keep an eye on developments on this bizarre story. Have some thoughts to share? Join me in a conversation. Shoot me a private email with your thoughts or ideas on a different approach to this story. As always, you can also send us a tweet. Email luis.gomez@stanyontribune.com, Twitter @ringgomez. Read the conversation on Flipboard.